there are certain physics concepts that we have been studying from such a long time, but we still do not know how important those concepts are. I am going to talk about those most underrated physics concepts. I am Jagriti Hinduja and you're watching The Curly Physicist. Starting with the third most underrated physics concept, Superposition Principle. There can be superposition of waves, but forget about it as of now. We are going to talk about Superposition Principle in electrostatics. Suppose that you have a number of point charges, and now that you want to calculate force or electric field on a particular charge by the effect of all other charges present. We can simply do it by calculating force between that particular charge and other charges individually and then adding them up. That's Superposition Principle. But now comes the main part. Why is Superposition Principle so special? The Superposition Principle seems similar to addition. We are just not adding two numbers, we are adding forces. When you are calculating the force between two charges, it is independent of the presence of other charges. Or in terms of electric field, the electric field created by a charge is independent of the presence or absence of other charges. And so you are able to add two forces together. This might seem so elementary for you, but think of a possibility that the presence of other charges affect the force between two charges. The mathematics would have become so complex. Maybe we wouldn't have been able to calculate force between two charges because there are so many other charges present. That's the beauty of Superposition Principle. Now moving on to the next most underrated physics concept, Pauli Exclusion Principle. Before we proceed, please subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram. It's The Curly Physicist. Before explaining Pauli Exclusion Principle, let me give you an overview of Uncertainty Principle. Although if you're here on this channel, I assume that you are familiar with these terms, Pauli Exclusion Principle and Uncertainty Principle, but still, so that you recall those concepts, I'm telling you again. Uncertainty Principle says that you cannot measure the position and velocity of a particle simultaneously. The more accurately you know the one, the less accurately you can measure the other. Uncertainty Principle is the uncertainty in position multiplied by the uncertainty in momentum should be greater than equal to h cross by 2. Everything in this universe can be explained in terms of particles, and particles have a property called spin. All the known particles in this universe can be divided into two groups. Particles of spin half, that makes up the matter in the universe, and particles of spin 0, 1 and 2, which are responsible for the forces between matter particles. Only the matter particles, that is particles of spin half, obey the Pauli exclusion principle, not the particles of spin 0, 1 and 2. There's a reason behind it, but it requires a new video to explain that concept. The Pauli exclusion principle says that no two similar particles can exist in the same state. That is, they both cannot have same position and velocity within the limits given by uncertainty principle. Now, the motive of this video, what makes Pauli exclusion principle so special? Imagine a world without Pauli exclusion principle. Under the influence of the force by the particles of spin 0, 1 and 2, the matter particles, that is particles of spin half, would have collapsed to a state of very high density. Pauli exclusion principle explains why they do not collapse. If the matter particles have very nearly the same position, then they must have different velocities so that they do not stay in the same position for so long. If the world would have been created without Pauli exclusion principle, then quarks together would not have formed protons and neutrons, and protons and neutrons would not have been together with electron formed atoms, and so we would not have been existed. Our existence is explained by Pauli exclusion principle. Pauli exclusion principle even explains the formation and stability of white dwarf and neutron stars. I shall be explaining it in a bit. a large amount of gas, which is mostly hydrogen, starts to contract in on itself due to gravitational attraction. And when it contracts, it starts to collide with each other. When the gas collides, it heats up the gas. And at this temperature, the hydrogen no more collides among themselves. They react, they form helium. And the heat released in this reaction makes a star shine. Now, this heat increases the pressure of the gas, which balances with the gravitational attraction and makes a star stable. The balance between this gravitational attraction and the pressure of the gas makes a star stable and remains stable for a long time. But obviously, we have a limited amount of hydrogen, and hydrogen is reacting among themselves to create helium. There will come a time when all of this hydrogen and other nuclear fuels that a star has will be exhausted. At this point, the star starts to cool. Now the heat, which was increasing the pressure and was ultimately balancing with the gravitational attraction to make a star stable, is no more there, and the star is cooling. So we have only gravitational attraction. And now the stars start to contract, and now comes the role of Pauli exclusion principle. Now, when the star is contracting, the particles are coming together to have same position, which they can't have according to Pauli exclusion principle. They must have different velocity so that they do not stay in the same position for long. This makes the particles move away from each other and the star expands. Now, the gravitational attraction and the Pauli exclusion principle repulsion is trying to balance the star, and the star again becomes stable. Earlier in its life, the gravitational attraction and heat was making the star stable, but now gravitational attraction and the repulsion from Pauli exclusion principle. And now, if the mass of the star is less than 1.5 times the mass of the sun, then the stable configuration of the star will be a white dwarf star. A white dwarf star is supported by the Pauli exclusion repulsion between the electron in its matter. Another possible final state of a star with a limiting mass of about 1 to 2 times the mass of the sun, but much smaller than the white dwarf star, is a neutron star, because they were supported by the Pauli exclusion principle between neutron and protons. Pauli exclusion principle is not just about calculating the valence electrons in an atom or determining the properties of solid. It's way more than that. Now, moving on to the next, the most underrated physics concept placed on number one is uncertainty principle. If there were no uncertainty principle, then the universe would have been completely deterministic. That is, we could have predicted what's going to happen in future if and only if we knew the complete state of the universe at one time. But in order to predict the position and velocity of a particle in the future, we should know the position and velocity of the particle at present. The obvious way to do that is to shine light on the particle. But as soon as we shine light on the particle changes velocity as it acquires the energy from the photon. So one certainly cannot predict the position and velocity in the future, as they do not know precisely the position and velocity in the present time. That's uncertainty principle. This principle led to the formation of quantum mechanics, in which particle no longer had fixed position and velocity, rather had a quantum state, which is a combination of both position and velocity. It was uncertainty principle that led to the formation of quantum mechanics that we are studying now. There's more coming now. Proton is considered to be a stable particle. But there's this grand unification theory, which tries to unify the electromagnetic force, strong nuclear force, and weak nuclear force together in a single theory. This grand unification theory makes a prediction that proton is an unstable particle and that it decays into lighter particles such as an anti-electron. The reason behind is uncertainty principle. The basic idea of grand unification theory is that the strong nuclear force at very high energies becomes weaker, and the weak and the electromagnetic force becomes stronger at that energy. The energy which is called as the grand unification energy, its value is around 10 to the power 15 giga electron volt. We cannot obtain such a great energy in labs due to obvious reasons, and hence we cannot experimentally check the grand unification theory. Now, coming back to our original proton instability problem, at grand unification energy, there's no essential difference between a quark and an anti-electron. The three quarks inside the proton do not have enough energy to change into anti-electron, but occasionally, sometimes a quark may acquire enough energy to change into an anti-electron, because due to the uncertainty principle, the quarks inside the proton do not have fixed energy. The uncertainty principle explains the emission of particles by black holes to stop the violation of the second law of thermodynamics. It predicts that just like virtual particles that carry the force, there should be virtual pairs of matter particles such as electrons and quarks. Uncertainty principle is the most fundamental principle of the universe that we live in. Whatever unification theory that is to come should incorporate this uncertainty principle in it, because it's the most fundamental and it's the most beautiful principle of all. Whatever that we are trying to achieve is the set of laws that predicts the events within the limits given by uncertainty principle only. And that's so beautiful. Consider subscribing to my channel, and don't forget to press the like button, share this video, and comment if you like this video. And do follow me on Instagram. It's the curly physicist.